Now let's talk about the norma frontalis. Norma frontalis means when we see the skull from the front, all the things which can be seen from the front, that comes under the heading of norma frontalis. So the bones which form norma frontalis are the frontal bone, which form the forehead, maxilla bone, this is maxilla bone, right maxilla bone, left maxilla bone, nasal bone, as I have already told you, it is a paired bone, right and left, the zygomatic bone, which is also called as the cheek bone, this is the zygomatic bone, mandible, which forms the lower jaw, so all these bones join together to form the norma frontalis or the viscerocranium. When we study the norma frontalis, there are different regions: frontal region, orbital region, nose, and lower part of the face. In frontal region, we have superciliary arches. These are the superciliary arches. They arise from the medial aspect of the face and goes laterally. The glabella, this one, the glabella is the meeting point between the two superciliary arches. There are some important features which are present in this frontal region. You can see these two are the nasal bones. There are many sutures which are present over here. So the suture which is present between the two nasal bone is called as internasal suture. The suture which is present between the frontal bone and the nasal bone is called as nasofrontal suture or frontonasal suture. The suture which is present between the nasal bone and the frontal process of maxilla. This is frontal process of maxilla. This is nasal bone. The suture which is present between the nasal bone and the frontal process of maxilla is called as nasomaxillary suture. This is also nasomaxillary suture. The suture which is present between the frontal process of the maxilla and the frontal bone is called as frontomaxillary suture. This is frontomaxillary suture. You can see over here. This is also frontomaxillary suture. Nasion is the point where the frontonasal suture meets with internasal suture. This is called as nasion. Now, look at here. This is the lacrimal bone. This is a very important bone which forms the medial part of the orbit. This lacrimal bone forms suture with this maxilla bone. And the suture is called as lacrimomaxillary suture. This is the suture. Nasolacrimal duct is a duct which starts from the medial part of the orbit and opens into the inferior meatus of the nose. So this is the opening for the nasolacrimal duct. Now, let's talk about the orbital opening. That was the frontal region. Now, let's talk about the orbital opening. So, this orbital opening contains eye inside it. The supraorbital margin is formed by the frontal bone. At the medial part of this supraorbital margin, there is present a notch which is called as supraorbital notch or supraorbital foramen. The infraorbital margin, this is the infraorbital margin, is formed by the zygomatic bone laterally and through the maxilla medially. Infraorbital margin. The medial margin of the orbit, this is the medial margin of the orbit, that is formed by this lacrimal bone, as you can see, frontal bone, this is frontal bone, and the maxilla bone. So, medial margin of whole of the orbit is formed by three bones, starting from the above frontal bone, lacrimal bone, and the maxilla bone. And the lateral margin of the orbit is formed by the zygomatic bone mainly. This is the zygomatic bone. So, that was the orbital opening of the norma frontalis. Now, we will go about the nose. This is the nose. The boundary of the nose is superiorly, it is formed by the lower border of the nasal bone. Inferior side, it is formed by the body of the maxilla. And on the lateral side, it is also formed by the maxilla. So, the nasal aperture is formed by the nasal bone superiorly, lateral and inferiorly, it is formed by the maxilla bone. Rhinion is the lowermost point of the internasal suture. The anterior nasal spine is a projection in the median plane in the lower boundary of the nose. This one. This is called as anterior nasal spine. Now, let's talk about the lower part of the face. This is the lower part of the face which forms the jaw. The upper jaw is formed by the maxilla bone. This maxilla bone bears the sockets for the teeth. And the lower jaw is formed by the mandible bone. This mandible bone also bears the socket for the teeth of the lower jaw. Let me repeat it for you. The lower part of the norma frontalis is made by maxilla bone and the mandible bone. The maxilla bone bears the sockets for the upper jaw teeth and the mandible bone bears the socket for the lower jaw teeth. In the mandible, there are two tubercles which are called as mental tubercles. And there is protuberance which is called as mental protuberance. There is an important foramen which is present on the sides. This foramen is called as mental foramen. During the development process, mandible was originally two bones. And in the development, these two bones joined together to form a single mandible. So, there is a small suture which is present in between the mandible which represents the two halves of the mandible. This suture is called as symphysis manti. Now, let me repeat foramen of norma frontalis for you. This is supraorbital foramen. This is infraorbital foramen. There are two foramen which are present on the zygomatic bone. Zygomaticofacial foramen and zygomaticotemporal foramen. And this is mental foramen. That's all about the norma frontalis. In my next video, I will talk about norma lateralis, norma basalis, and the interior of the skull.